Alpha Mind Power Online Live Classes by Sri Mata Vijayalakshmi Pandeyan. Mobile app Alpha Mind Power.
Namaste. Today I'm going to speak to you about our thoughts. How powerful are our thoughts? Can they affect others? This is a question which many people have asked me many times. Particularly when I do counseling, this question comes up very often. And people always would like to know, do my thoughts affect others? Can they affect somebody when I have negative thoughts about them, particularly negative thoughts? And I will speak about this with an example. There was a lady who came for counseling and she particularly asked this question. She said, I have this question in my mind. Can my thoughts affect my husband? I said, why are you asking this? Then she said, I will tell you what happened a few days back. She said, my washing machine started giving me trouble. So I was finding it very difficult. Then I spoke to my husband in the night and I told him, why don't you get it changed? Why don't you get it exchanged? Let us give away the old one and get a new one, which means a little bit of expense. Then the husband said, I cannot do it now because their daughter was just doing her 12th standard. She's just about to finish. So he said, the college admission is there. A lot of expenses are there. Wait for some 3-4 months, let us finish all that and then we'll think about all this. So this lady says, I got very annoyed, I got very angry and frustrated because when the washing machine is not doing properly the work, then it is a burden for me. Again and again, I have to keep on doing the work and he's not understanding. So throughout the night, this was going on in her mind. She said, why is he not understanding my difficulty? For the daughter to go to college, it's going to take at least 4-5 months. Till then, do I have to wait? So this was going on. And she said in the morning, anyway, she got up as usual. She started cooking, preparing breakfast and lunch for her husband and children. She said, I was doing all the work, but throughout my mind was actually scolding my husband. She said, I kept on saying, why can't he understand me? Why can't he do this for me? He's always like this. He cannot spend for my happiness, for my comfort. So this was going on in my mind continuously. And anyway, I packed his lunch and gave him. He had breakfast and went to the office. But she says in the evening when he came back, he was not looking all right. And when I asked him what happened, finally we came to know that he had fever. So then she said, I gave him medicines and then it took him about 2 days to become normal. So she said, this was not the only incident. This is the latest incident. But even before this, she says, many times it has happened that whenever there is some kind of a misunderstanding between us, I get very angry and throughout in my mind, it keeps running and I keep on almost cursing him because anger always gives rise to curses. We may not logically think about it that way, but the mind becomes so negative when someone doesn't do what you want them to do for you, then you become a little annoyed and frustrated and you say, he will never be happy. He is not making me happy. He will never do this. He will not be able to complete this. All these thoughts come, the negative thoughts. So she said, these thoughts keep on running in my mind and every time I have such thoughts, she says, my husband becomes sick. I've seen it a few times now. That is why I came to ask you whether my thoughts can bring about sickness for him. Then I told her, you must understand that it is not just the thoughts. What are you doing at that time? You're cooking the food. And food is a very good medium to carry energy. If you think about our forefathers, those who can remember your grandfathers or great-grandfather, great-grandmother, etc. They would never go and eat in anybody's house. They would consider it, you know, like a crime almost. They would think so much before they would go and eat or have even drink water in somebody's house. And those days they used to carry water wherever they went in a kind of, they used to call it a guja. And they used to drink that water. They would never drink water from outside because they were very much worried about the thoughts in the mind of a person who was serving the water or who was serving the food or who was cooking the food because that energy gets into the food or water and they do not want to get that negative energy. So they made sure that even if they travel, they always either cooked their own food or carried their own food and had that. So I explained all this to her and I said, see, water and food are very good mediums to carry energy. So when you cook, if you are mentally cursing your husband, then that energy will go into the food that you are packing for him. And definitely when he eats that food, he falls sick. So this lady was quite a little bit alarmed when I told her that. I said, that is why you must understand the power of your thoughts. We talk about black magic. We talk about so many things. One does not have to do any black magic. Even if a person feels jealous of you or if a person is very angry with you, it will affect you if it continues for a long time. Definitely the intensity, if it is very intense, it will affect you. And particularly when you look at a family, in the family, if there are 5 people, 6 people, 4 people, and one person is angry with another person, you are living under the same roof, but you are angry. So what happens if you fight, you quarrel and finish it off, it's better because the air clears completely. But when you don't even fight, you don't talk about it, you're silent about it, but the mind is going on and on and on over time, it's working too much and all the thoughts are negative, then you are affecting the other person, and same way the other person is also affecting you. So when the thoughts are negative about a person, they definitely affect that person. So that is why it is very important that our thoughts are always positive. Once you understand that our thoughts can affect another person, then we will understand how much it is a responsibility on our part that we keep our thoughts positive, at least about the people with whom we are concerned. So think about it and take a hold on your thoughts and always keep them positive.